This video is brought to you by the FarmerKlein YouTube channel. Be sure to like, subscribe, and comment.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the Farming Simulator 22 Map First Impressions video. Today, we're going to take a look at AlpenTal, or AlpenTal. I'm going to go with AlpenTal. But before that, this video is brought to you by CBW Farms LLC and Joe Sixpack American. Thank you for being farm barons. So the AlpenTal map can be found over at the farmingsimulator.com website or the in-game downloadable content menu. And as of the 1.0 release, this map is available for all platforms. Let me read you some of the description. Welcome to AlpenTal. This is a fictitious map that has everything you need for a cozy round farm. This map includes 63 plots, 60 fields, of which 11 are meadows, 2 forests, a cow yard with farmhouse, vehicle dealer, cattle dealer, BGA, various points of sale, precision farming ready, and this is the map author's very first map that he created with his son. That just is a great thing overall. Now, this map does have some required mods. So the required mods include basic pastures pack, bunker silo set modular, concrete bunker silo, deep well, European fence pack, feed mixing plants, liquid manure shop, and the Rheinbach farm buildings and small stationary workshop trailer. In addition to those required mods, we are going to be using mods we typically use when we look at maps, that is additional field info, additional game settings, animal food overview, field lease, field calculator, precision farming, and straw harvest. Now, we'll tell you, I loaded this map up in farm manager mode, and I will tell you that you do have your farm built out exactly how you see it here in new farm mode. In addition, you do have your starting machinery in those alternate game modes, but of course you do not own any land. We'll point out that the starting farmland is extremely cheap, so you may want to start in farm manager mode, because you'll then be able to maximize the amount of money you have at the very start. Let's go and take a look at the PDA itself. This is a smaller size map. I would say it's probably about 1/3 the size of a normal map, given the fact that we've got some pretty good chunks taken out here. This map does have all the standard crops available to us in Farm Sim 22. In addition, if you do have a premium expansion loaded, you will have those crops as well. Take a look at our farmland screen. You'll see that we own a big chunk of the map, as well as farmland 45. So your starting farm is actually located here on what I would call the unbuyable land. But on this map, it is very much buyable, and it is farmland ID 63. And it is absolutely free. So again, in Farm Manager or Start From Scratch, you can start in those game modes, buy this land, and then basically have your new bank balance that is more than the $100,000 that you get in new farmer mode. In addition, we then also have farmland ID 45, which is field 45, is 1.22 hectares in size. We do have a BGA on the map that is also a part of that unbuyable land that you do own at the start as well, but you will have to buy the BGA before you can make use of it. Let's go ahead and take a look at our farmland lease screen. This is going to show us all of the buyable farmlands, how large those farmlands are, if those farmlands include any field, what fields are included, and then lastly, how much is that farmland going to cost us? Now, one thing that I am seeing here is that the farmlands and field numbers line up one for one all the way up to farmland and field 60, which is something I really do like to see, because it does make comparing that with our field calculator screen a whole lot easier. This is going to show us the specific sizes of each particular field. And I would say these fields range from small to medium. In fact, the largest field here, I believe, is going to be 5.82 hectares in size, and it's going to be field 54. Let's go ahead and take a look at our precision farming soil map. This map is using a custom soil map, so let's go ahead and see how that is being applied to these fields. As you see, we have got a fairly big swath of sandy loam coming down through the kind of the northeast, making its way down toward the center where it then transfers over into silty clay. And then we have swaths of sandy loam and loamy sand running across the map right there, just north of the starting farm. Overall, we've got a fairly good concentration of loam on this soil map. Take a look at our crop counter. We do have the standard base game crop counter available to us here on this particular map. And if we take a look down through all of our prices screen, you'll see that we do indeed have the ability to sell all of our base game crops that are available to us here in FS22. In addition, we have the ability to sell our eggs, wool, and milk, and our silage, hay, straw, and grass. As we continue down through all of our base game production items, we once again do indeed have the ability to sell all of our base game production items. In addition, we do have the ability to buy bulk lime, and we also do have the ability of getting rid of our stones if we are playing with stones enabled. Now, sadly, the trend that we are seeing with other maps is we do not have the ability to sell any of our washed vegetables with the farm production pack, or nor do we have the ability to sell any of the platinum expansion production items. So if you are looking to do a little bit of forestry and a little bit of platinum expansion production, you will need to put down your own sell point. We do have the ability to sell all of our premium expansion crops and production items. In addition, if you are playing with pumps and hoses, you will have the ability of getting rid of your separated manure, and you will also have your ability of getting rid of your hay and straw pellets if you are playing with straw harvest. Taking a look at our starting machinery, it's all new. None of it is leased. It's all fairly well maintained. We do have 60 sheep in a sheep pasture that is a little bit removed from the starting farm at the start. The cow shed at the starting farm does not have any animals in it at the start. We do have contracts on this map. We do have a feed mixer production also on the starting farm, which we own at the start. That is going to take hay, silage, straw, and mineral feed and mix up total mixed rations. As well, this map does not have any collectibles. Let's go ahead and take a look at our starting fleet. We start out with a 4755 and a 7810 medium tractor John Deere variety. We've got the Topliner 4090H harvester that is paired up with the 4090H header, and of course the 4090H header trailer. We've got our 1986 pickup truck, as well as a Rudolph TDK 301 RP trailer. We've got the Amazon Cinto 4000 super cultivator, the Nordstein HK 25 NS3030 cedar and power harrow combination. We got the Mega 1200L Hardy sprayer for herbicide and liquid fertilizer. The ZATS 3200 fertilized spreader. We got the Brandner TA 12050 power spread plus manure and separated manure spreader. We have the Farm Tech Super Cease 800 slurry and digestate spreader. The GMD 3123F front mower. The Zelon CFS 2501 DO forage wagon, as well as the Silo King TMR mixer and the MKS liquid tanker. We have the MES 400 silage leveler, the Q3M front loader arms, and for the front loader arms, we have a pallet fork, bucket, manure fork, and bale spike. And then we also wrap up with a 900 kilogram John Deere front weight. With respect to mods and DLCs, this map does not have any custom vehicles or implements built in. Let's just quickly jump over to the starting farm. Now, I will tell you, I loaded this map up with a low-end system that has integrated graphics. And when I got away from the farm, I had no issues maintaining 60 frames per second. But around this starting farm, even just with this starting machinery, I was seeing frames dip into the 40s. So if you do have a lower end system, you know you may be suffering with frame rates on this map. Farmhouse, we have our sleep trigger and wardrobe trigger. We have our fuel point, our fuel storage. And we've got a nice shed here with our harvester and header in it. We have our silage bunker here, and then we have a well located back here behind the silage bunker. Now, with respect to, can the farm be customizable? The answer is yes, with an exception. Three exceptions. The deep well, the silage bunker, and the feed mixer here are all permanently a part of the map. You cannot sell these. Well, I take that back. I was able to sell a feed mixer after I realized I needed to click here at the interactive icon. I was trying to sell a feed mixer by clicking on it in other areas. I was not successful, but I could not figure out how to sell the deep well or this silage bunker no matter what I did. In addition, you are seeing curbs here at this farm. These curbs will interfere with your ability to place buildings. If you are going to be placing buildings, you're going to need to enable free place mode in order to basically not have to worry about those curbs. Free place mode, you may say, I don't know what that means. Well, free place mode is something that was added in a fairly new update soon after the game released. But if we look at our F1 menu, you'll see we have toggle free place mode. Right now we can't put it because we're trying to place this on a curb. But if we toggle free place mode, now we can position this on the curb and it won't matter. So if you are looking to make customizations to this map, be sure to enable free place mode. Otherwise, you're going to be very, very limited to where you can put things. Here at a cow barn, we have our dairy trigger. We have our food and straw troughs. Then we're going to have our cow drop-off point. 45 cows in total. Over here we have our food mixer, so we have our output pipe, we have our interactive icon, and then we're going to have our dump point for our feed mixer. We've got a slurry tank over here. We have some additional implement storage. We have our silo dump and fill point. And that there, gentlemen, is going to be our starting farm. We do have bale storage here. 450 bales or pallets can be stored here. The bale storage is separate from the building. So if you do sell the building, you will still have the bale storage, or you can sell the bale storage and maintain the building. I do like that combination, so the player does have the ability of kind of picking and choosing. And lastly, we do have a maintenance trigger here at the farm as well. Let's get a little bit of altitude. And we'll take a little look around here at the starting farm. Not really the biggest farm area. So if, again, if you are looking to customize this, do note you will be a little limited. And of course, then having the inability of getting rid of the silage bunker and the well here in the middle will somewhat impact your ability to customize. And of course, the curbs everywhere else will have some impact as well. Before we get on with kind of the sell points and other points of interest, I do want to fly over here to the free range sheep. So these are the sheep that we have on our farm. We have our food trough, our water trough. We have our sheep delivery point. We're going to hold a total of 120 sheep in this facility. And then we have our wool spawn point located right here. And we've got a nice set of poles that are going to be kind of telling us where these sheep will be roaming. So that is kind of neat. But we do want to do something with respect to building out this field. You know how far over we can go before we're kind of impacting the sheep's area. Just to the south and west a little bit, we're on the road from our starting farm, which again is located right there. We're going to have our sugar mill. So we have our spawn point, our interactive point, and our dump point around back. We have our oil mill, interactive point, dump point, and pallet spawn point. We have 8 productions built in to this map. We have a spinnery, sawmill, dairy mill, oil, sugar, grain, EGA, and the feed mixer at the starting farm. Here we have a grain sell point. Where I talked about the sheep area there to the left. Continue to make our way around. We have our biogas plant. We will need to buy the biogas plant. If we do purchase the BGA, we will be able to sell the biogas plant. Basically, what you see here will be sold, with the exception of the utility poles. So these utility poles and light poles are going to remain. So it may not be that useful in selling the BGA. I was not successful in selling these silage bunkers. We've got a 3-sided silage bunker, then we have a 2-sided with 1 open side silage bunker. And then we've got a small implement shed with a maintenance trigger also associated here. We have our stone crusher. We have our digestate output. We have a buy point for slurry. We have our animal dealer located right here. Just down from the animal dealer, we have a farmer's market sell point. And I have to say, for this being the map author's first map, really did a really nice job. We got our sawmill here. This is just in front of the animal dealer. So we have our dump point for our logs, our wood sell trigger. We have our pallet spawn point. We have our interactive icon and our fill point for our wood chips. Just down the road, we have 2 kind of restaurant sell points. One located there, one located right here. And then we have the dairy right next to that. Just give a little bit of an overview of this northern part of the map. Really, there aren't any sell points or anything up here. But it is a really nice kind of setup. Like these houses kind of up here on these hilltops overlooking the valley. With respect to our score, we are going to give the map a full point with respect to production being built in or areas set aside for such. We're also going to give the map a full point with respect to the ability to sell all of our production items, default game crops, and animal outputs. We have our base game grain mill here with our dump point, interactive icon, and pallet spawn point. We then have our spinnery right across the street, dump point, interactive point, and pallet spawn point. Just down the street from that, we have our fuel. We have a grocery sell point. And then we have our vehicle dealer. So our dealer trigger located right here. Let's go ahead and get our Mahindra. There we have our Mahindra. Decent sized area for our machinery to spawn in at here. Shouldn't have any issues with vehicles spawning in with respect to contracts and such either. even though we do have some fairly small fields on this map, I would say. Then we have our dealer trigger located inside. But even though we do have these markers here, they are simply kind of marking off the pit that is covered. This is not the trigger. The trigger is actually outside here. We do not have trigger markers. It would be nice to see those trigger markers there, but they are not. So that is pretty much the map. Because just down from the shop, well, we're back to our starting farm. Now, with respect to the rest of our scoring, we are going to give the map just a half a point with respect to the farm being customizable. While we can sell most of the buildings, which is a good thing, the fact that we have the silage bunker, the deep well that can't be sold, and the deco items like the curbs that also can't be sold, because I did try to sell those curbs, I couldn't figure out how to get those sold, that will impact to some degree your ability to just place things down at the farm. We're going to give the map a full point with respect to buildings using the new texturing technique. Let's go ahead and take a look at our landscaping textures here as well. We do have some custom landscaping textures also in here, which is always good to see. I was hoping we would have some lattice work because I did see that at some of the sell points. Then we have fairly standard plants and trees. And of course, we're going to have a bevy of buildings, productions, and other things because of those other required mods. And then lastly, with respect to triggered interactive areas being clearly marked, we are going to have to deduct a quarter of a point because of the vehicle shop with respect to the dealer trigger. So that's going to give this map a score of 4.25 out of 5. A very good score and a very attractive map for being the map author's kind of initial foray into building maps. I do hope that he continues this and look forward to his second release. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments below with respect to AlpenTal or AlpenTal, however you want to pronounce it. And until next time, happy farming.